The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. Excellent kick. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today.
And down he goes at the 25. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback.
That makes it second and 10.
From their own 25-yard line,
it's second down.
I got number 23. I got you, 23.
Red two.
Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
Orange three.
False start. Offense.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Still second down.
Bring it. 52's the mic. Watch Mike.
Green nine. Look out.
Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately, taking back a yard.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
That'll bring up third and long.
We got third and long here.
Ball on their own 19.
Watch the pass.
Mike, 55. Right there in the middle. 55.
He chucks it downfield. And he hauls in the deep pass. Touchdown, Gamecocks.
They pretty much had their way with the defense there. Terrific play.
And he adds the extra point. So a short three-play, 80-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys got to be coming over the sidelines after touchdown saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
So the score now, 7-0. Georgia's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go, Kirk.
Brad, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
And he hits him hard at the 41.
I'll tell you what, this defense better start to get pressure on the quarterback. They're giving him way too much time back there to throw the football.
From their own 41-yard line, it's first down. Gains his way to the 49-yard line. A gain of 8 on the carry.
That makes it second and 2.
Check tight right. Solo out there. Check the outs out there.
Four down.
They'll work the left. Good outside run there.
They should continue to run the ball. If they keep this up, the defense will wear down very quickly.
From the 45-yard line, first down.
Check Mike 11.
And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
He gets out to about the 25-yard line. From the 25-yard line, it's second down.
Ready, easy. Stingray.
He's tackled at the 30-yard line. They'll make the sack.
He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds and those receivers might have been open.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. It's up. No good. He hooked it left. Let's find out if the defense has made any adjustments after giving up a touchdown on that last drive.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
So it's second down and 13 yards to go following that quarterback sack. South Carolina is up by a touchdown.
Red two, orange three.
Here's the give. He's taken down around the 32-yard line.
Loss of two on the play. That makes it third and 15.
Man left, man left. Three down, three down. New Mike 52, Mike 52.
And they got him.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. I'm going to be interested to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
Fourth and long here after the sack. And this one is a beauty. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. The Gamecocks really took care of business on defense that first time out, Herbie.
One of the great traditions of college football is this defense and the way they play with such passion and enthusiasm in this environment. We're seeing that again today.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Got an opening. And he is drilled at the 48.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
From the 48-yard line, first down. Slings it, tackle right around the 36-yard line.
Number 12 makes the tackle at the 36-yard line. First down.
Quick strike to the receiver. And they make the stop at the 23-yard line.
Number 12 rings him down at the 23-yard line.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 23. In the shotgun and five wideouts.
Here we go.
Incomplete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
He steps up, and he's level at the 27.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. He just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
It's third down and 14 yards to go now after that setback by the sack. Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback, and he's taken down at the 27-yard line. Looks like the defense was in man coverage there, fellas, and that's why they stopped that screen.
Yeah, and when the secondary isn't dropping back in the zone, it makes it difficult to have success with that kind of screen play.
He gets it up, and it's long enough, and he nails the long field goal. After a quarter of play, we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. 7-3, Gamecocks. Georgia to kick. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. So the draw to the halfback picks up four. Second and six. Ball on their own 29. South Carolina is up by four. They'll keep it on the ground again. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
That is a loss of 1 yard. That makes it third and seven.
Drop deep, drop deep. Mike 55.
Dog four. Green up.
And he's hit immediately. From their own 35-yard line, it's first down. They bring him down in the backfield. And the linebacker comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
Immediately tackled. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one.
Ain't no such thing as a loss. We taking wins home. Mike 55, Mike 55. Dog 40.
And he's tackled at about the 43-yard line.
That'll make it fourth and two.
He puts it away, and it's a great kick. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Quick strike, and he drops it. From their own 20-yard line, second down, five wide. He's got it with room to run. They'll bring him down at the 33-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 13 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Roger, Roger!
They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker.
Hey, check Mike 11, check Mike 11.
Let's go! 59, field
high! And he's tackled in the open field.
That's good for him. First down.
Tight right, tight right. Four down. Hey, check Mike 11, check Mike 11.
Let's go!
Off play action. Now he's on the move. He's taken off. Tackle made at the 28-yard line.
Gain of 18 yards. First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. They come out in an empty backfield.
Ready! Let's go!
complete over the middle. And he tackles him hard at the 15-yard line.
Good job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
He's on the run. Looking for the corner. Touchdown, Georgia. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. Georgia is lining up to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And they can forget about returning this one.
You know, we're getting so used to pinball football with a lot of points. Kind of fun to see defenses play this way.
Kind of refreshing, isn't it? I mean, every single week we call games and you're seeing scores in the 30s and 40s. This is one of those low-scoring games. Which offense will get that big break? Eventually, it could be the team that wins it.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possession.
He's going to try and scramble. Decides to slide. He might have gained a yard on that scramble.
We've watched this guy play, and over the course of his college career, he's made some spectacular tackles. Nice play.
Quick release, tight end, incomplete. And there wasn't anyone in the vicinity.
I think the ball just slipped out on him.
It's third and nine. Ball on the 26. Completes it across the middle. Brought down at midfield. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. A great tackle at the 47. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
From the 47-yard line, second down.
Mike 55, Mike 55.
Check, check. Dancer, dancer.
The ball is loose. It's recovered. And down he goes. Around the 36-yard line. The Gamecocks call a timeout. That's their second of the half. They're going to review this fumble. And I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this call.
So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
Red 2, yellow 3, yellow 3.
Slings it out there. Tight end's got another one. He's tackled around the 22-yard line. He's on the run. He's taken down at the 17-yard line.
Kill, kill, kill! Green!
That brings him second and five.
Green nine, green nine! Red seven, red seven! Go!
He scrambles. He keeps it. What a play, and that is first and goal. Throw in the end zone, touchdown. And that one worked just like they draw it up, Kirk.
Yeah, Brad, you're exactly right. Offensive line did a good job of protecting the quarterback. Good route by the receivers. Results, touchdown.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. So that's an eight-play, 64-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. South Carolina lines up for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish.
So their last drive resulted in 6 points. Do you think we'll see the same result on this one?
They ran the ball extremely well on their last drive. And until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field.
Looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. A great first half comes to a close. 14-10, South Carolina.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnovers. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game, but you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002 in a certain formation where it's Tucson open stud, and they got three receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You're looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here. Got a good... Well, a good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later.
Yeah.
We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Are they stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
Welcome back to the action. Second half just about set to begin. We got a tight game here. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Caught, open field. The defense provided good pressure on the play, but they just weren't able to get to the quarterback that time.
It's a decent pickup that time on a well-designed play.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down.
Hey, check Mike 11.
Scrambling around, and they got it.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
It's third down and 7 to go. Ball on their own 28. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
That's exactly how they drew it up on the sideline, and now they get the ball back.
That brings us 4th and 7.
And this one is a beauty. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. They are ready to begin another drive. South Carolina holds a 4-point lead. He gets
rid of this one.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He's gobbled up in the backfield. Just nowhere for the ball carrier to go as the linebacker met him in the backfield.
Boy, what great play recognition by this linebacker. He saw the run was coming, and he just shot through the gap and made a great tackle.
From their own 29-yard line, third down.
Red two.
Tackle at the 40-yard line. He really got a hold of that one. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Quick throw out to the receiver. And they make the stop at around the 38-yard line. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice gain.
So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down.
Hey, check Mike 11.
Gets to about the 41-yard line.
Gain of three on play. Let's go.
First down.
Here we go, here we go. Tight right. Four down. Hey, check Mike 11.
And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
I don't think the play developed the way it was supposed to, and the net result is a loss.
From their own 39-yard line, second down. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run. Him hard at the 33.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. Tackle made at the 31-yard line. The last time this offense had the ball, it was three and out. South Carolina is up four. And he's taken down around the 41-yard line. From their own 41-yard line, first down. Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in.
That makes it 7-10.
Where's 52? Watch 52. Let's do the mic.
Now he tries to buy some time. And he's level at the 44-yard line. He scrambled, but he didn't get much.
Brad, this defense reacts too quickly for a scramble like that to work. He needs to spread him out a little bit more to try to create more room to run.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 49. Looks middle, got his back. Couple of yards there.
It's a nice play by the defense to shut down all the lanes, so this halfback wasn't able to make anything happen on that play.
Yeah.
Here's the punt. No, they're going to throw it. Airing it out long. He's taken down at the 18-yard line. Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And he's tackled at the 14-yard line.
Number 33 on the tackle at the 14-yard line. That makes it second and six.
From the 14-yard line, it's second down. South Carolina is up by four. They bring him down in the backfield.
Loss of one on the play. Third down.
This is the eighth play of this drive.
Don't say nothing.
Get the T's and Mike. Watch Mike. Watch Mike.
On play action.
Number three was the intended receiver on the play.
Fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. It's up, and it is good. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Gamecocks continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. They'll go ground, and they get nice yardage on that run. So at the end of the third quarter, the Gamecocks in front, 17-10. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action.
Four down. Hey, check Mike 11, check Mike 11.
Ready, wide 59.
Under pressure, just throws this one away. Now it's third and six coming up. Ball on their own 29.
Three down. Hey, check Mike 11.
And he throws right away.
This is a quarterback who trusts his receivers, and he knows they can make plays. It's like those two were playing catch out there.
Second and one. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one.
Four down. Hey, check Mike 11.
He makes his way to about the 28.
First and ten.
Four down.
Hey, check Mike 11.
Here we go.
He steps out at the 28. From the 28-yard line, second down. To that quickly. They'll bring him down at the 22-yard line.
Number 22 on the tackle at the 22-yard line.
And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Four down. Hey, check Mike 11. Check Mike 11.
Ready. Black hot.
Runs in and oh, what a hit. So they're going to go for it here. Across the middle.
Did you see how calm he looked as he stood back there and read the defense? When you know what you're doing and what should be happening, it makes things a lot easier.
10th play of the drive. Pulls it in and he's in the open field. 6-yard pickup.
The defense here let the halfback roam free for a second, and they were able to connect for a short gain on the play.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
He's got an opening.
Nice run there as they work the outside.
That's a gain of 6 on the play.
And this is the 12th play of the drive. This defense not wanting to give an inch here. Puts on a move, touchdown.
Unbelievable. That was a big-time example of responding when the pressure's on.
The extra point to tie this game up. And he converts the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And you know, it's basically like we're starting from zero here in a one-quarter game now. Every possession is vital. On the ground, left side. That's a great tackle at the 35-yard line.
Good solid running right there. Getting past the defensive lineman and into the secondary before he could be stopped.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line. Pressured and brought down.
Call it a loss of 10 yards. That'll make it second and long.
Larry.
Mike 55.
I know he ain't got it.
Red two. Go.
He goes downtown. On the reception, look out. Nobody there. He's taken down right around the 4-yard line. That'll push him over the 100-yard mark in receiving.
Even when he isn't open, the quarterback will still throw him the ball and just let him make a play. It really shows the trust that the quarterback has with his receiver.
First and goal as they look to take the lead. Just under 2 minutes in the game.
Here we go. Touchdown, South Carolina.
Yeah. The play clock's at double zero. They just took too long.
Delay of game. Offense.
Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. And he tacks on the extra point. So a four-play, 75-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys got to be coming over to the sidelines after touchdown saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
The score now, 24-17. This one's going to be down to the end zone for a touchback. The Bulldogs have got to be just a little bit careful that they lean too much on a star player here in this stage of the game.
Yeah, but having a quarterback that understands what this defense wants to try to do to slow this offense down is very, very important. Now he just got to stay calm, make good decisions, and move his offense down the field.
Got a man. Watch out here. And down he goes at the 39.
First and 10.
Here we go. Most blue, 88. Blue, 88. Easy. Lucky 95.
Catches it, but he steps out. He would have been better off letting that one go. From their own 38-yard line. Second down. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. They pick up a good 6 yards there.
It's a decent pickup that time on a well-designed play.
Him out at the 45-yard line.
Well, that's one of those plays where the wide receiver is expected to make something happen after the reception, but the defense wasn't giving up anything.
This is their last opportunity to stay in the game. A big stop by the defense, and this game is in the books.
Gets it. He's in space. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 28-yard line.
That's a game of 27 on the play. First down.
From the 28-yard line, first down.
Pick it up, guys. Pick it up.
Hey, check.
We have less than a minute to go. They bring the quarterback down.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
Quick toss. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 18.
Let's go!
They'll make the sack.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
And if they don't convert here, then the game is over. He's going to go for the home run. Wow, you just got to love it for this defense. They come up with the stop of the ball game and maybe the season. And they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
These guys came up with a touchdown on their last drive, and they'll be hoping for another six on the board here.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
So it's second and 12. Ball on their own 43. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. And the quarterback's going to take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had. This one's all but wrapped up with the final score, 24-17, Gamecocks. Let's get Kirk Herbstreit's final thoughts on this one. Herbie, what do you got for us?
Well, this one really could have gone either way. Georgia had plenty of chances to win this football game, but it wasn't meant to be today. All you can do now is try to bounce back after a close loss like this.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.